This is Match Game 75, production number 0508, and it's take one. Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Pflug, Richard Dawson, and George Dillafont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Agitated, aren't they? Well, I thank you very much for that. It has warmed the cockles of our hearts, hasn't it?
Yes, it certainly has.
Has everyone?
Does that tie
ready?
Go with that suit?
Yes, that tie goes with that
oh,
suit.
Okay.
You can wear stripes with diet, can't you?
Mm-hmm.
Say yes. Yes.
So.
Yes.
Anything when we go to Encino, he wears his little polka dot pajamas.
She's
oh, well, we won't
making
talk about it.
A little joke,
oh.
You see.
Helen, don't worry about it.
I guess you're all ready. So
I don't know if it's true what I read in a magazine about Charles and Brett.
About Charles and Brett?
Mm-hmm.
What'd you read in the magazine about
that
Charles?
They were having a thing going on.
No kidding. Really? Well, let's go right to the horse's mouth.
If you people watch late television, you'll see I've been announced to marry another woman.
Oh!
Notice how emotionally distraught she is over me. I mean, I happen to live a wild, exciting life.
Really?
I had pancakes for breakfast.
I can
You're crazy.
That.
Say hello to these two pretty ladies here, Diane Armijo and Kathy Brown. How are you? Diane is our current champ. She's won one game, has $600 to her credit. She's now going to be challenged by Kathy Brown. We haven't found out anything about you. Shall we do that now?
Okay. I'm a California girl. I was born and raised here.
Yep.
And currently, what?
You have a nice California suntan look.
Thank you. And currently, I'm studying dietetics at California State University at Northridge. And I'm married to a wonderful husband, Mike. And we've been married for a year and a half.
Okay. Well, we wish you the very best of luck, Kathy.
Thank
we'll
you.
Start this game in a minute or so. But right now, we got to do a little business, and this is the nature of that business. All right, I'll push this button and ask our challenger, Kathy Brown, to make a selection.
B, please.
B for Brown. All right, here we go. Zelda was voted
the what?
Miss Banana Split.
Bullshit.
Now, here it is. Instead of giving her a crown, they put blank on her head.
Oh.
You got it?
Yeah. All right. She was. Did you say she was voted Miss Banana Section?
No, Miss Banana Split.
Oh, Banana Split.
Yes.
I...
Instead of giving her a crown, they put blank on her head.
Put blank on her head,
right.
Did they? Yes.
Blank on my head and you in my arms.
Blank. Well,
it's Banana
right.
Split.
Yeah. No.
All right. Ready, Bert. Back to Kathy Brown. Kathy, Zelda was voted Miss Banana Split.
Wait a minute, I haven't finished.
Well, your light was on.
I know, but I took it
well,
out again because
the stop burglar is coming.
Oh, Jesus.
You said blank on her head.
All right. Are you ready, Kathy? Zelda was voted Miss Banana Split. Instead of giving her a crown, they put blank on her head.
Whipped cream?
Whipped cream. Okay. She say, whip of the cream.
Whip of the cream is good for the banana split. Yeah. However, I put chocolate syrup on
chocolate
before
syrup.
I put the whip of the cream. I'm sorry.
That's also good. What do you say?
Well, I don't feel so bad about throwing away maraschino cherry now.
No, you don't. You shouldn't.
But I didn't put whipped cream. I put chocolate syrup.
Yes.
Chocolate syrup.
Are we keeping you up?
No, I'm just upset because
oh,
I
see.
Get
well, don't be upset. You'll get a right answer.
Whipped cream is a wonderful answer. Ah, nuts!
Nuts! Almost got me there, Charles.
That's how I move it.
Yeah,
you know,
sure.
Away from row to row.
Yes, Miss Joanne, honey.
Where, honey?
What'd she say? She says instead of giving her a crown, they put whipped cream on her head. What do you say?
Zelda was my grandmother's name.
She was.
Yes, I don't know if I like that.
Why don't you name the baby Zelda?
Oh, that's a good idea, Brad.
Zelda.
I think that Kathy Brown has brilliant taste.
Yes,
because I said not whipped, but whip cream. I
whip
think it's
cream.
The same.
Okay, same thing. Absolutely. That's a very high caloric answer. What
it's
have
also
you got?
Very cruel to whipped cream.
Yes.
Poor devil just lies there. I always put hot fudge on.
Hot fudge. That's good.
Oh, it's lovely.
What do you say?
I say I'm getting hungry.
You are. Well, let's get out of here and get something to eat.
Okay. A cherry.
Okay. So we've had it all, the ingredients there, didn't we? The cherries, the whipped cream, the hot fudge, and everything. Diane, this is yours. Now, Long John Silver says, "Aye, mateys." He says, "I didn't get a wink of sleep last night because I had a blank in me wooden leg."
Isn't it adorable when he does that?
He says, "I had a blank in me wooden leg. Couldn't sleep all night." That's what Long John Silver
said. Can I tell you something?
What?
To the producers and everybody, I don't like the John Long Silver questions.
Yes.
But this was the best. This was a terrific John Long Silver.
It's Long John Silver.
John Silver.
Long John Silver.
I didn't know he was Jewish.
Diane, we're ready for you. Long John Silver said, "Aye, mateys, I didn't get a wink of sleep last night because I had a blank in me wooden leg."
A termite.
A termite.
A termite just kept eating away all night long.
Okay.
And that's what I said, the termite.
What do you say?
I say I think he's gone bananas.
Yeah, well, that's...
I said termite!
Termite, that's two.
That's how the Italians say it, right?
What?
Termite.
Termite, yeah, that's how they say it, yeah. Termite. What do you say?
Orkins come quickly.
Really?
Yes.
Last night, because I had a blank in me wooden leg, and she said termite. Oh, you got it, too.
Yes.
Oh, termite. You. Five bugs, Richard? Termite. Now, I suspect we're going to have one dissenter in the bunch, and here she is.
The lady who gave us cherry.
Yes, right.
Are you ready for this?
What?
Well, I had something larger in mind.
Like a sailor?
Most definitely. I said a woodpecker.
Okay.
A woodpecker.
So in round one, it's four, it's five for the champ and one for the challenger, and round two is coming up right after this.
No, you're not hallucinating. You're watching That 70s Hour. There's more match games still to come, only on GSN.
We go to round two now, ladies. Here we go. Kathy?
B.
B. All right, here we go. Now, let's see. You do not play. Everyone else does. The Tidy Bowl Man said, he said, "I've been in this business too long. Yesterday, my blank turned blue."
I just basically, you're another pretty face.
Say it
you just
again.
Have to go along.
The
say
tiny bowl man said, "I've been in this business too long. Yesterday, my blank turned blue."
I don't know.
That's nice.
Okay, everybody ready? Yes, here we go. Kathy Brown. The tiny bowl man said, "I've been in this business too long. Yesterday, my blank turned blue."
Face.
My face.
Is that bad? Face?
Face?
Yeah.
But what would you say? Oh, my boat turned blue.
I want the studio cleared.
Yeah, clear the studio for him. What do you say? Let's see. She says, "My face turned blue," and the audience is screaming, "My boat turned blue."
Boat turned blue.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Blue boats.
Blue boats, I know.
His boat is blue.
My boat is blue.
We were sailing the other day.
Yes, the audience, what do you know?
I don't have a blue boat.
What have you got?
I said his eyes turned blue. Because everybody knows the tiny bowl man.
Let's go. Come on. I'll take it. So now, Kathy, you got to match everybody else to stay in the game. Brett,
what
it's up to you.
And then
she
I'll...
said, yesterday my face turned blue.
Oh, her face.
Right.
Who out there said rowboat?
Yeah. Everybody.
Well, I hate to do this to you, but that's what I said, rowboat.
Rowboat. So that means Diane wins the game. Let the rest of the hand go. Body and body. Okay. Okay, you stand by for a moment or so, and we'll get back to you. Right now, we tell Kathy Brown it was a pleasure meeting her.
Oh, it was so much fun. Thank you.
Thank you. And we've got a gift for you. Kathy Brown, ladies and gentlemen.
Goodbye.
Now, shall we have another go at it? All right. You feel a little better now, don't you? You're not as nervous as you were the last time because you're now a veteran. You've been up here. This is your second time. You got $700. You're going to try for over $5,000 now. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. blank core, C-O-R-E.
Oh.
Now, the answer they gave most often, remember, is worth $500. You match the next one, you get $250, and the bottom one, $100. Whom do you call on over here?
Brett.
Oh, I'm torn between two wonderful answers.
No doubt.
How about hardcore?
Hardcore is one, okay.
Charles?
Do you know why I don't go to hardcore movies?
Why?
Because I don't want to see anyone have more fun in an hour and a half than I had all my life. However, there was that autumn of 56.
Yes.
No, Apple Core.
Apple Core. Whatever. Okay. She says you, Richard. Now you got
what
Apple.
Charles is in reality.
What?
Rotten to the core.
Rotten to the core. Maud, you are rotten to the core. Remember that marvelous old B. Lily song? All right, so you've got those three now. Hardcore, Apple Core, and rotten to the core. Do you want one of those?
Apple Core.
Apple Core. The audience is in your corner with that one. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. So let's begin down at the bottom and reveal, if you will, sir, the $100 response. Rotten to the core is the answer Richard gave.
It's worth every penny of it.
Right, indeed. All right, still looking for Apple Core. Here is the $250 response. Hardcore. That's $203.
And Apple was my first choice.
Yes,
last chance. Here it is, the $500 response. Apple Core, congratulations. Okay, Charles gave you that one, didn't he? Okay. So now you're up to $1,200, and that means you're going to play for 10 times 500 or 5,000, but remember, you have to match one of them head-to-head exactly. Which one will it be?
I'll have to go with Charles.
Charles, it is. Are you ready, sir?
Okay.
Okay. You may face me.
Good luck, honey.
And here we go. This is $5,000 worth. Arabian blank. Arabian blank. Okay, he's finished. Now we need an answer from you, Diane. One you think will match his. What do you say to that?
Night.
Arabian Night. Well, you got a screech out of them. They think you're right, but
how many Arabian Nights were there?
101.
You know,
1,001. Well, it was a discount.
But does anyone know the name
at the
of
White
number?
Front store,
you know the
100.
Name of number 82?
Number 82.
No, Armando Amihao.
No. Okay, that's your souvenir, and while you're getting it all together, we'll get a little message here going. You now have $6,200.
GSN presents...
Finch and I teamed up around 1948. We worked together till 1952, and we had fun. It was all spontaneous and ad-lib, and in those days, I used to do voices. We owned New York. I mean, everybody listened to Rayburn and Finch.
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
And he had a wonderful quality. He'd laugh at any slightly humorous thing I said.
Now we're ready to start another game, and to do that, we very happily present to you Mr. Oliver Chamberlain. What do you say there? Oliver, please tell us a little bit about yourself. Oliver wants to wish you some luck there. You've had a lot of luck already. You got $6,200. Now let's find out about you, sir.
I'm a liquor salesman from Los Angeles.
Oh! Gotta give that man a round of applause.
That'll be enough of that, my dear.
I have a 2-year-old son, and my wife and I are expecting again in August.
Again in August. Okay, well, good luck to you, Oliver, on your coming blessed event. And here, too. Would you please make a selection?
A, please.
A? All right. You may not know this, but there were actually 4 little pigs in that story from your
really?
Childhood.
Yeah.
Now, when
that's all, folks.
That's it, right? When the big bad wolf came to the 4th little pig's house, the wolf ran away holding his nose because a 4th little pig made his house out of blank.
Once more.
Well, you see, there
really were 4 little pigs, Charles.
Oh, 4 pigs.
When the big bad wolf came to the 4th little pig's house, the wolf ran away holding his nose because that 4th little pig made his house out of blank. Hello there.
Have you made the reservation?
Yes, you look very chic tonight there.
I'll just wear what
I'll be
I have
proud
on.
Of you. Oh, that's great. Yes.
Hi.
Hello there.
Hi.
Just watching.
Hi.
Or there he is, the whole thing. Fourth little pig made his house out of blank.
Yes.
What did the other three make their house?
Well, you know, one was straw, one was brick, and one was wood, wasn't there? One wood?
Sticks.
Yeah, well, yeah, sticks, straw, and the bricks.
Now, there were sticks and stones may break my bones.
Yeah, that
is. But names will never hurt me?
Yeah, that has nothing to do with what we're talking about.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'm
yes.
Only God can make a tree.
All right. Okay. You need a little help in spelling? I'll be glad to do that.
She needs a little help in writing.
Just do anything and I'll figure it out. I'll spell it as we go along.
I can't figure out how to spell it. Well, isn't it nice that Joanne's going to have a baby?
It's very weird. Well, you know what I'm trying to spell?
Yeah.
But how about I'm spelling it wrong?
Well, you mean this?
Oh, if she'd only go into labor, we could get rid of her.
Is that what you mean? No?
Is this what you mean?
Oh, no. You mean that?
Yes.
No, she means...
Oh, you should come with their writing.
No, come on, throw those in. Is that what you want?
This is what I want.
Okay.
Did you put the right one in?
All right. Here we go. Ready. All right, Oliver. There were four little pigs in reality, according to this little fiction we're trying to foist off on you. And when the big bad wolf came to the fourth little pig's house, the wolf ran away holding his nose because that fourth little pig made his house out of blank.
Lard.
Lard. Lard. Does lard have a bad odor? I suppose if you let it lie around long enough, it does. But don't we all? Bert, what did you say?
Well, that pig ran away.
Does Lard have a bad order?
No.
I didn't think. He ran away holding his nose because the house was made out of bandini or manure.
Oh, you are so inclined. Okay. Yeah. Hi, Brett.
You know that spoiled lard smells almost as bad as manure.
Really? Okay, Charles.
You know, I was in Hello, Dolly originally. Did you know that?
Yes. I believe. Don't you remember?
And it's like... There was a wonderful phrase, money is like manure. It's no good unless you spread it around. I put skunk hide.
Skunk.
Yes. Or skunk duty.
Okay. Sorry, Oliver, we're not getting any lard for you. But it's just,
yes,
the
are.
Other stuff is sure piling up pretty high. All right, you're on, my dear. Yes. Oh, a little lipstick?
Yes, I blotted on you.
Oh, I see. All right.
I couldn't think how to spell this. It kept coming out hunks. But it was skunks.
Skunk. See, what did you use? It was. I thought she was trying to spell corn shocks or something like that.
You know, I was in Hello, Solly.
Yes.
Wonderful line there that manure's like money. It's no good unless you...
Are you going to spread it around?
Yes.
That's
a dynamite line. So naturally, I built the house of garlic.
Garlic is very good.
And it burns down.
Smells wonderful.
Yeah. Pork with garlic is fantastic.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Indeed.
Just a dash of formica.
Yes, Scarlo, right. It's wonderful.
Little dill there. Yes, ma'am.
What do you have?
I said, the pigs are southern, aren't they?
I take offense to that.
I do, too.
What did you say, Joyce?
No, some of the south? These four little pigs lived in the south. Oh. That's all.
That's what you,
you
say.
You all oink.
So, I therefore...
said they built them out of, he built them out of turnip greens.
Turnip greens. That's pretty bad.
She's another crazy.
Now, that's your question.
Answer.
I'll get to you in a moment, but right now we got this for you. Pay attention. Well, I thank you one and all for joining us here on this day. This is Gene Rayburn for Match Game 75. Goodbye.
Tomorrow on The Amazing Race.
We're wasting time.
The pressure is on at Hong Kong.
Are you idiot or what?
You're playing a game. We're here to win.
I can't do it anymore.
The Amazing Race, tomorrow night at 10 on GSN.
GSN. The network for games.